Hey everyone, Scott Auckerman here, and welcome to another fine Earwolf program on the Video Podcast Network. Stay tuned for
Who Chatted?
Oh, my favorite.
Episode of Who Charted on the Video Podcast Network. This is episode 147 if you're listening to it in podcast form. Tonight we have Jason Mantzoukas joining us to count down two charts and to answer your Twitter questions. I'm your cuckoo, Kulap Vilaysak, and he is your wee wee, Howard Kramer.
Hello, Kulap.
Hello, Howard.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you this fine evening?
I am doing well. I had a busy day and evening, and now I'm here.
Well, tell me what you did. I need to know.
Oh, well, I went to Nerd Melt last night. That was a lot of fun.
Okay.
Special celebrity drop-ins. Todd Barry.
Ooh.
Louis C.K.
Heard of him.
Exciting. Brett Gelman.
Oh, yeah, him.
Yeah. Then I went listened to some trap music.
What? Live?
Yeah, at the club.
Oh, and Howard, you are a new man.
I'm a busy guy.
Okay.
I'm a man about town.
And that dovetailed into this morning.
Oh, yeah. That's why. When I woke up, I saw you had texted me at 9:30 a.m.
Yeah.
I'm like, who's her podcast partner? Who does she? What world is she in? 9:34 a.m., I'm getting inquisitive texts.
Then I retexted you again with a question mark at 12.
Right. And I woke up at 2. That's because I'm busy. Man about town schedule.
Yep, busy day. Busy day, Howard Kramer. Should we introduce our guest?
Please.
All right. You know him from TV, movies, and of course, podcasting. He's been voted America's favorite asthmatic by numerous fake magazines. He's Jason Mantzoukas!
Rock and roll!
Oh, yeah.
Woohoo!
Oh, yeah.
I wish I had my asthma inhaler to just punctuate that.
Do you have asthma, Jason?
I do.
That's something we've not discovered.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, I'm full of maladies. I went to a doctor once, and for the first time, and was kind of telling him all of the medical things that are wrong with me or have been wrong with me, and in the middle of it, he kind of stopped and looked at me, and he was like, wow. You really got a bum unit.
You know what I would have said?
Yep.
I would have said, you've got a full medical IMDb. I would say it in a positive way.
A full medical IMDb. All right.
Yeah,
all right.
Yeah. In that regard, your star meter is...
Oh, on the rise towards death.
Is your asthma, is it airborne? Is that the type of asthma you have?
What do you mean?
Is it air and stuff that will cause you to...
Oh, you mean like pollution and smog and stuff like
right.
that? Yeah, that exacerbates it. But mine is much more like I take a bunch of... I will go in like have an asthma attack just like...
Just for fun.
Just for fun. So right. I take a bunch of medications just to mitigate that.
Okay. What if during sex has it ever come into play?
No, it hasn't really. I don't have very athletic sex.
Okay.
Okay.
I just kind of... I sleep most of the time during
okay.
sex.
Or, it's like two boards. That
yeah,
connect.
Like she can do whatever she wants, but I'm just going to sit there and try and make as little noise and as little motion as possible.
Try to scare her away.
Yeah,
I got
yeah,
you.
Yeah, yeah,
possum
yeah.
Possum style.
Yeah, I don't want to show her what I'm really about, because then she might run away.
Right.
And
I have that same.
What are you really about?
Oh no, I can't tell.
Oh well, yeah. I mean, just like, give us a little tease.
That's the secret. That's the secret.
Oh, kissing. You know, like kissing and stuff.
Wow.
Kissing and touching on boobies.
Oh, Howard, similar style.
I'm more of a cram stuffer. I try to...
jam it in?
Yeah.
Yep.
Ah, that term, cram stuffer. It never gets old for me.
Well, it's good because it's something that's been around since before you were born.
The
stuffing,
act of
cram
it or the term?
The cram stuff. It's just, I mean, even before humans, before we took this
What's
form,
interesting is that cram and stuff are the same. The cramming and stuffing but that, are the same. They are both verbs.
Right. But think of how redundant sex is. You do it, and it's like you do the same thing 1,000 times.
Yeah.
Wow, wait, 1,000 times? That's when you make sweet,
like
sweet
in
love.
A night?
I think
in
if you put a counter on it, I bet it's a thousand times.
I beg of you to do that.
What?
I need you.
How many times do you think you've had sex?
Well, oh, I don't know.
Isn't that a great? Like, I knew a guy who, when we were younger, when we like started having sex, he would like mark on his calendar when he had sex.
Right.
And then because he was, and I was like, why? And he was like, well, later I can look back on it and see how much sex I had.
I like that. He could chart it.
Yeah.
That's what we do. Right there.
That should be one of the charts you guys look
at. The sex chart. Kulap would beat me.
You're writing it down?
I was going to count down.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1
Kulap's fascinated with my scribblings.
Always.
No one, even the chartists don't care.
I don't know if that's true. Chartists, let us know.
Let us know.
Tweet us at WhoCharted.
Hey, and send in your tweets now, questions for us or Jason that we will take towards the end of the broadcast.
Oh, that's exciting. Should we start our show? Let's hear that music theme. Let's hear that music theme live.
Oh, yeah. Hold on.
Oh, wait,
I got new lyrics. They're on my phone.
You do?
No.
No?
I've been doing new lyrics on these. I'm going to do it again today. All right.
Oh,
all right, hit it.
Oh, gosh. Here we go.
Borders, books, it bit the dust. Circuit City filled with rust. Tower Records, that shit's gone. But the music chart lives on and on. And on and on and on and on. And on and on and on and on and on. And on and on. On and on and on and on. Tunes. Yeah. All right.
That's pretty good.
I felt good about that one. Perhaps we'll include that in some year-round type of bundle that we'll have out for the chartists. That's just a billboard. All right, go Kulap.
I didn't know you guys did bundles.
We are thinking about
digital
bundles. It's a new way to go.
Digibuns.
Digibuns.
Hot digibuns.
Hot digibuns.
This music chart is Billboard's dance / electronic songs. So this is
right up my alley this year.
Oh,
he's
boy.
He's very into EDM.
Really?
Yeah.
Dance music, Jason, it's healthier than ever. It's more vibrant than ever.
Oh, for sure.
Better than ever.
I think David Guetta, does David Guetta qualify as this?
He was one of the highest earners last year.
Yeah. Like in terms of like, like tickets and all that kind of like made crazy money.
Crazy money. Skrillex 2. These guys are big time.
Skrillex 2? There's a second one? Now?
There's like Gallagher 2.
It's like Gallagher 2, Skrillex 2.
Yeah, it's his little brother.
Skrillex was like, I don't want to do this anymore. Can somebody take over?
Right.
Skrillex 2.
Skrillex 2.
Electric Boogaloo.
Shaves his head on the other side, but and plays the smaller markets, secondary markets, Des Moines
and
Tuscaloosa.
Moving down for number 4 to number 5, Daft Punk featuring Pharrell Williams with Get Lucky. Oh, guys, this is going to be dancey the whole time. Oh, yeah. This is the other summer song that won't die.
Oh, yeah.
In 21 weeks on the Dance Electronic Songs chart, it peaked at number 1.
What do you think about this song? It's been in your face all summer, Jason.
When it came out, I liked it fine. I am actually quite. I do really like the Panda Bear song that is on that Daft Punk record.
Right.
I much prefer that to this, although this is fine.
Okay.
I like it. I like it fine. I'm happy when it comes on, but I don't hunger to hear it versus I will go and play that Panda Bear song.
Right. Panda Bear song, a lot less overplayed.
Yes.
Yeah. This one, Get Lucky. It has been a soundtrack to our lives. Who would have thought just 6 months ago we never ever heard it before? It'd be hard to.
Only been 6 months?
It came out like right at the beginning of summer, maybe around May, April.
I guess you're right. It feels so long.
Yeah.
It's been a long trip with this song.
Sure has.
Yeah. I'm ready for it to be done.
Yeah.
I'm ready. I've heard it enough now that this and Blurred Lines that I'm like, if I don't hear that for a bunch of months, I'm pretty cool with that.
Right. Well, yeah, I mean, that's the thing about popular radio. They often are not done with something when you're way done with it.
Oh, yeah.
You'll just keep hearing it.
Up from number 5 to number 4, Zedd featuring Foxes with Clarity.
All right. That is Zedd and Foxes with Clarity.
The song peaked at number 2 in its 35-week run on this chart.
I like the song. I like the end of it the best.
Was that the end?
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Do you mean you like when it ends the best?
No, it just, you know, songs have a beginning, middle, and end, and this one kind of kicks in for me at the
end.
Oh,
yeah, I see what you mean. Yeah, okay, yeah.
It's too poppy up top.
I just, the part of the song I like the best comes at the end.
I see.
These fellas come in and they start chanting.
Oh, okay.
Feels a little like soccer hooligans have entered the recording studio.
Is that what you think every time you hear it? Uh-oh, yeah. Soccer hooligans.
Yeah, yeah. They come in, they headbutt
the little girl. You should
probably
say football. Football hooligans in that sense.
Well, why?
Football, maybe even.
Okay. He's on the league. I got to take his recommendations when it comes to sports.
Please. You shouldn't, actually.
Wait, you've got a special episode coming up on The League, right?
Yeah, next week is an episode of The League that Seth Rogen and I wrote, the entirety of which is just about Rafi and Dirty Randy on a murderous adventure.
Wow.
In Los Angeles. There are midget porn stars, there's murder, there's gunplay.
Wow.
There's a gigantic fish-shaped pool. Guys, there's some pretty insane shit.
This sounds like an...
Wow.
The gloves are off.
Must see TV.
Yeah.
Is Seth a big fan of the show?
He was. They had him come in and do this same character a couple of seasons ago, and I think he was super into just how improvised and fun it was. And then he's come back a couple of times and is great. He's a fun.
I've not noticed improvisation in his work. Is that something he does?
It's something he's trying out. It's something he's trying out. He's just giving it a shot.
Right. Floated out.
He's
there.
He's stretching, guys. As a performer.
That's great.
You, a big part of Rafi's character is knife play.
Yeah, yeah, oh yeah.
Is that something you brought to the table or was assigned to you?
I brought it. I did it. I started asking for knives and then they gave me switchblades. And so now it's so funny when I get into my little room that has like my wardrobe in it and stuff laid out for me, it's like terrible clothes. And then on the table is like a gold medallion, a gold bracelet, and a switchblade.
It's like a Grand Theft Auto
every day.
Character.
And then I'll say this, and then what the addition this season has been hot dogs.
There's always, yes, that's right.
There's always hot dogs
pocket
ready
dogs.
In case I need
pocket
a pocket
dog.
So there's a lot of pocket dogs. There's a certain point where I think it to me is such a funny bit that at the most inopportune, weirdest times, Rafi pulls a hot dog out of his pocket. But what it has led to now is me, like on certain days of the league, having to eat like upwards of 10 hot dogs.
Ooh,
with special buns, no less.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
You got
egg-free
buns. You gotta have egg-free buns.
Guys. I'm not kidding around.
No.
Egg-free buns.
Moving down from the top spot to number 3, Lady Gaga with Applause.
It's gonna be the hardest one to dance to.
I don't like this song.
Yeah, I'm not into it.
I like Lady Gaga, don't like the song.
I like the verse where she sounds like she's in Berlin at a cabaret. This part.
From her upcoming album, Art Pop.
That part's good.
That's okay. I agree with that.
Yeah. Gaga, she's back. Where did she go, Jason?
I mean, I believe she went to Bushwick. I believe she's been in Brooklyn for a long time.
Is that true?
Something like that. Yeah, she's been, I don't know.
And then she
did own property there? Oh, she had a hip problem?
Oh, yeah. And then she did a bunch of naked stuff with, what's her name, that artist? The one I mean.
Hugh
Picasso.
Hefner.
Picasso, Pablo Picasso.
Yeah.
She did a great interview on the Howard Stern Show last year that was fantastic, where she explained a lot of her process,
yeah, I
played
heard that.
Songs. It was terrific.
It was great. She talked about her dad.
Yep, and her grandfather dying.
Yeah. She's a smart gal.
Yeah.
She's thorough.
I like it.
She's thorough?
Yeah. She knows her stuff.
Do you wish to be as thorough as Gaga?
No. I have more of a loose style, more of a drunken monkey style.
Oh, interesting.
Wow.
Happy accidents, mistakes, that kind of a
thing.
I
like that. Yeah. I like that.
I don't want to be too controlled.
You can't be too perfect. Otherwise, you challenge God's supremacy.
That's true, too. And I don't, he's got enough headaches. I don't need to distract him.
I'm going to start a movement based on that. Guys. Gaga, both of you are unimpressed.
I like her. I just didn't love this. I don't love this single.
She's yet to put out a song that has all good parts in it for me. It's usually at least two of them I could do without.
Mm-hmm.
But that's the beauty of DJing, I guess. They could cut those out and just play the good ones.
Is that what they do at the club when you're there?
They do that at the club, yeah. It's crazy at the club. You never know how much of the song they're going to commit to.
Sure.
So they start a part, and you start to get excited about it, and then you realize, oh, he was just using that to build into some other record.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, how many times a week are you going to a club now?
I'll be at the club 2-3 times a week.
Is it the same club?
Whoa.
No, different clubs,
are
different
venues. Are you performing?
No, I am.
You're just there listening, dancing.
I say I'm deeply embedded in youth culture.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Are you writing a book?
In my mind. In my mind, it is a book.
Gotcha.
You know what it is? Like when you were 16, 17?
Yeah.
I didn't see any need for to go past that. That's the pocket I liked and enjoyed. It's like, I'm 2 years away from having to do anything serious, and I'm just listening to tunes.
So you're trying to get back to your 16, 17-year-old responsibility-less.
That's what I think. He's always been there since that point.
Interesting. You're not getting back. You just are still there.
You're hanging on.
I like it. It's not even hanging on.
No,
it's like, okay, you know how they have analog recording?
Sure.
And somebody like Jack White says that's the pinnacle.
Yep.
Never needed to move forward to digital.
That's
what I say about 16, 17. That's the peak. That's when it's fun.
But Howard, what about committed relationships?
You could have those at 16, 17. They just probably won't last.
But what about a lasting
And they mean
love?
So much, too, at that age. Those young relationships are so intense and so meaningful. You know?
Right. And they ruin you for later, isn't that true?
Not if you stay there.
Oh, God. That bitch.
Oh, Jesus, what? Jason. Jason, let's list your last five girlfriends in order of bitchiness. Five. Coming in at five.
Margaret.
Margaret.
Coming in at number four.
Pam.
Pam.
Did you say it like that?
Pam. Pam, I want out. Pam, I can't live like this.
Later for you, Pam.
Later for you, Pam.
In the middle at number three.
Melanie.
Oh, Melanie.
Oh.
Ugh.
Jason, come in here. I need help with my son.
Melanie, shut up.
Rising to number two.
Shauna.
Hey, Jason, fix this iced tea.
Shauna, you slut. Sorry, Shauna. I apologize.
Shauna broke up with you, I think.
All of these women broke up with
me.
At the top of Jason's most bitchiest girlfriend list at number one.
I'm just not blanking. I've made up so many good names, and now I've come up with a...
Cora?
Cora, yes.
I remember when you dated Cora.
Cora, yeah.
You weren't happy.
The Explorer?
Cora, no, it was short for Coraline. She was a 3D animated character.
French chick.
Yep.
Yeah, what was the problem with her?
She was animated.
Oh, got it.
Yeah.
She was an animated child?
She did not. She was an animated child, which was... had problems on a number of levels. She did not have functioning genitals.
Did you have to draw her food for her?
Yep. Oh, yeah, yeah. It made going out to dinner almost impossible because she can only eat animated food, and P.S., nobody has that shit.
Oh, man.
Draw me some grapes, Jason.
Draw your own grapes, Cora. God damn it.
Well,
I'm a great boyfriend.
Are you?
Yeah.
You're firm.
I'm a terrible boyfriend.
Loving but firm.
What do you lack as a boyfriend?
I don't know. No, I think I'm actually a good boyfriend. Yeah. All bits aside. Yeah.
All bits aside.
I think I'm a pretty good boyfriend.
Okay.
I'm great. I'm good at getting like gifts and stuff. Like I love when I'm dating someone and it's like their birthday or something. I'm like, ooh, I'm gonna get you a million cool, funny, interesting, neat things.
Oh, so you go
all
to Urban Outfitters? You go to Urban Outfitters,
yeah.
You buy her some of those
books.
I get her
like a fake old turntable.
Yeah. And then you go to like, Spencer's Gifts.
Yep, Spencer's Gifts, and I get her some fundy undies.
What about some album picture frames?
Oh, 100% album picture frames. A lava lamp.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Everybody gets a lava lamp.
Nice. Spencer Gifts.
Yep.
Got it.
Yep.
Up one and number two, Lana Del Rey and Cedric Gervais with Summertime Sadness Remix.
Boo. This is...
Ricky Gervais's brother.
Yep.
I actually like this song.
Yeah, this is good. Controversial statement. I kind of like her voice.
Oh, I like her voice too.
I don't always like her songs, but I think I like her affect.
She does. She has a haunting affect.
Yeah.
I would say that's true. She, to me, it's funny, this song, because it's so nonsensical.
Was I supposed to do MDMA before I came?
You could.
I mean, it should have been offered to you as you walked in.
It was not.
What? Video Podcasting Network.
A bunch of open trail mix was what was available. Guess what I'm not going to eat? Loose trail mix.
Oof.
Guess what? Things that are not gonna enter my body. Loose trail mix.
Yes.
And loose, like, I'll be like, you know, like, they'll have this all the time on, like, on sets and stuff, like at craft
bowls
service.
Of things.
Just, it's like a bowl of M&Ms.
Yeah.
You know what? Just have some packets of M&Ms out. Because what I don't want is, like, every gross grosso, like, rummaging around, putting their hand back in the thing, just, like, junking up the stuff with germs.
What if it could make it taste better?
What?
What if there's something on their hand that just mixes really well with an M&M?
Like what? Like what, Howard?
Well, maybe some pizza sauce.
Okay. Well, now we have okay. So what? So you're positing the notion,
yeah,
that there are people on sets with just pizza juice on their pizza sauce on their hands.
Yeah.
We call it pizza juice.
Could
pizza
be.
Juice.
Yes.
Just rummaging around. You know what? It's insanity, but possible. And because of that, I would not eat that.
Well, let me ask you this question. Would you say there's nothing that could be added to M&M's to improve their taste?
Peanut butter.
Yeah, peanut butter.
But
would you? Salt and pepper? I don't know. Where are we going with this? I'm
saying that it's possible.
Wait, let me ask you. Do you think that M&M's and pizza sauce taste good together?
No, but I'm just saying, whatever it was, you never know what magical. A lot of times when they set out to discover stuff, they wind up discovering something else.
Is this a, you got your chocolate and my peanut butter? No, you got your peanut butter and my chocolate.
No, she said peanut butter. No, I don't know where that came from.
We just invented Reese's peanut butter cups?
We just did, yeah. You guys, you're not ready for this knowledge.
And you're
yet.
Talking about something, maybe Reese's pizza butter cups?
That's beautiful. We could have just invented a great tie-in.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
Cross promotion.
Who charted pizza butter cups?
Are these types of experiments something you do in your own home?
No.
Okay. Okay. Fair. So fair.
All things being equal, that song is fine.
Yeah.
It's nonsense to me. It's a silly notion of a affected young girl.
Yep.
But some reason, it works. That's a remix. Yep. Her version is very slow and downtrodden, which is like reading a teenager's diary.
I would pay money to read a teenager's
diary.
You
would?
Would you?
Like a real teenager.
Yes.
Like I would pay an amount of money to every month be sent a teenager's diary in the mail. Like a Netflix system but a real teenager's diary.
And
so
not
that
a
it's
blog.
Like really mundane.
Yeah.
No, it's their private diary that is not meant for public consumption. And I just get to read it like a novel.
Right. But then what are they writing in while you have it?
Oh, it's like, you know, I'm reading one of their finished ones.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. You know?
Okay.
Or copies of it, right?
Yeah.
Okay. We could probably work this out financially and
you know
the details.
What? I suspect this is the wrong thing to do, but you know what, teenagers? Just feel free to send me your diaries.
I like it.
Go ahead. Go on to the earwolf.com. Look at our
God.
P.O. box.
This is, you know what? I regret this instantly.
Earwolf
Please do not.
Media, care of Jason Mantzoukas.
Look at me. Do not send me your diaries. Do not. I don't want to read your diaries.
What if we took messages?
Because you know what's going to happen? You know what's going to happen?
What?
A bunch of nerdy, fat, sweaty dudes are going to write diaries. And send them to me. That's what's going to happen.
Tell you what, those same nerdy, fat, sweaty dudes are the ones who are making those M&M's taste so delicious.
They're like a pizza sauce all over their hands?
Yes.
Hey, pizza hands, guess what? Don't send me your diary, pizza hands.
Send me your M&M's.
Up from number two to number one.
Number one.
Avicii with Wake Me Up. Wake me up. What's the dance that June taught us this week?
Oh, yeah.
What is that?
That's
not really a dance.
It's a dance to this song that I guess Lizzie Kaplan showed her, where you just sort of put your hands up and you look at the sky, and it's not about you being with anyone, it's just about you being here.
Oh, really? This is nonsense.
What? Come on, Jesus.
If Lizzie Kaplan is responsible for it, I will not participate.
I don't know what you're doing because I'm looking up.
We're judging you.
You know, 11 weeks on the chart.
Go ahead.
This song's fine.
I like this song.
It's whatever.
But your point that you made this week is valid. It is a little like Hootie and the Blowfish.
It sounds like Hootie at the Grand Ole Opry. One of our chartists sent me something today. He said, what's the difference between this and Cotton Eye Joe?
Yeah, great question.
It's like hillbillified with a 4-4 beat.
Mm-hmm.
What are you looking for?
You okay, buddy?
Drop my bottle cap.
Oh, it's okay. You don't need it.
Well, that's good. Yeah, but I don't want to.
Are you worried that water? You're not
going to
finish that water before you travel? What's going to happen?
I'm just worried. I don't want to leave the studio dirtier than I found it.
Good for you.
Oh, wow.
Good for you.
Something the Sklar brothers taught me.
You're a good camper.
That's right.
The Sklars taught you that?
They did. They had a workshop, pod workshop, when we first got. I think you were sick that day.
I probably was.
Sklars walked me through a lot of the etiquette of podcasting.
I forget. They're your mentors, right?
They are. I've done my one-man show, Sklar Tissues, my one-man show about the Sklar brothers. I perform at a black box theater in Montecito.
Are they still the Earwolf TAs?
Yes,
or
they are.
RAs?
Yeah.
RAs?
Yeah. Both. They're both.
I still know what you meant.
It should have been RAs. I blew it.
They have a sense of authority about them, and also you trust them, like a good RA.
Absolutely. I go exclusively to them when I need condoms.
Do you?
Oh, wow.
Yeah. They give away free condoms. They have to. They're the Sklars.
Wow. They
I have didn't
their
know
own.
That.
Brand?
They have their own brand of condoms. Yep.
What is it? Ray J?
It's yep. It's Randy on one side, it's Jason on the other. Glasses, no glasses.
Oh,
I like it.
That's sweet. Guys, let's take a quick break if we can.
Fine!
Do you mind? Let's take a quick break. We're gonna at the tiniest break, and then we'll be back for the movie chart. We are back on Who Charted, live streaming on the video podcasting
network.
I'm Cuckoo.
Wee wee.
And we're with
Jason Mantzoukas.
It's true.
Zooks, there it is.
Go for it.
Is that how your fans greet you?
Yep. I did a show once at UCB called Zooks, there it is.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Oh,
you
wow.
did?
Yeah.
Wow.
What was the show like?
Oh, it was just me and a bunch of people improvising.
Oh, God. I just wish it was you constantly entering.
Zooks, there it is.
And people going, Zooks, there it is.
Zooks, there it is.
All right, Howard, are you ready?
Movies, yes, I am.
Let's hear that theme.
Movies, they're just like tweets. They release them constantly. Most of them we don't need to see. But when you get a good one, ooh-wee, movies.
Yeah, classic. Great.
I'll tell you a movie that I enjoyed. I'm rocking this shirt right here. This is from The Dictator.
Oh, look at that. It is The Dictator.
Zooks, there it is.
Funny. That's me.
Jason
Mantzoukas.
That's
not me, but it's my movie. Yeah, yeah. Funny.
That's cool.
I've never seen that shirt.
It's cool, huh?
Yeah.
How much?
I mean, $25.
Okay. After the show. I'll be walking. Hey, listen. I got this shirt with Brody Stevens at a special screening at the Arclight.
Of The Dictator?
Yeah, I got a free medium popcorn.
Ooh, I love this.
Popcorn?
I wasn't invited to this.
Nope. It was for plebeians. Water and this shirt. So it was a great day.
That's a pretty good deal.
And I saw the movie and enjoyed it.
Excellent.
This movie chart is the highest grossing dance movies 1977 to present, according to Box Office
Step
Mojo.
Up 3D.
Whoa.
Better be on this list.
Oh, I'm not giving anything
Step
away.
Step Up to the Streets. Better be on this list.
Aye, aye, aye. Coming in at number 5, Save the Last Dance.
Oh, that's a good one.
Dance?
Do you remember it?
Oh, yeah. Julia Stiles? Oh, yeah.
I guess it was pretty tough. Leaving all your friends. To say all those goodbyes.
Cool outfit.
Slamming outfit. Oh.
That's right.
Sarah, how you get your legs to twist like that?
I used to dance.
You used to dance.
It's really not a big deal.
I think it is.
You should hit steps with us tomorrow night.
Steps ain't no square dance.
Oh yeah.
Right, I dance in circles, probably around you.
She does have sass.
Oh man.
Look at that.
Seems like they're letting anybody in. Quit it, Nikki. I'm walking on eggshells.
eggshells just because you brought the Brady Bunch to the Negro Club?
What?
Race is a factor in this one, I'll tell you that.
Sorry. What's he doing? Two-stepping?
Maybe you want to hook up
2001, guys.
Yeah, sure. If you want.
There we go.
Make that sound.
All right. It's a big one.
Total gross, $91 million.
Yeah.
Preview.
2001 will always be remembered for this film above anything else.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Sure.
I don't remember anything else from that year. 2001?
No. Nope.
Uh-uh. There was only one thing.
Yep.
Save the Last Dance.
And also September 11th. Also the events.
Yes.
Hey, were you at a high school like that where it might be urban people teaching you how to dance?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Where was
it? No, I was not in that kind of... I didn't go to a high school like that. No, I went to a high school that was predominantly white, so much so that all black kids in my school, for the most part, were bused in from inner-city Boston. Like, they were bused from inner-city Boston to my suburban Boston high school.
To learn how to dance?
To teach us how to dance.
Oh, to teach you.
Okay. Yeah, specifically.
What type of extracurriculars did you do?
I did a lot. I did a bunch of sports. I did random, you know, like we did a comedy show that I would do, or I did like model Congress, or
Whoa.
I was class treasurer. I
Wow.
did tons of shit.
You were always a busy guy. It
always
sounds
a busy guy.
Yeah.
Always busy. Yeah. Anything to like not go home.
What would happen there?
Nothing.
Oh.
You're just bored.
Oh.
Yeah.
What sports did you play?
I played soccer and track. Soccer and track.
This guy played track.
Oh, yeah. What'd you do?
I was 800 meters, senior year, 800 meters.
I like that.
What about you?
I was a sprinter.
Yeah.
And I was a sprinter primarily.
What were you, a Saucony guy? Were you a Adidas fella?
I was a Saucony guy for trainers,
right.
Like for just running. But then for spikes, I wore Puma, I believe. Spikes.
Puma, okay.
What were you?
I was a Nike fella.
Oh, nice.
Oh, all the way.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah. You know what I loved about running track? It gave me a lot of wind. What do you call that? Stop. Don't leave me hanging, gang.
Gas.
It gave me cardio.
Oh, yeah. You said wind instead of cardio?
It gave me my wind.
Oh, I see. So it gave you endurance.
There
you go. And you know what I liked about that? When I would ride my 10-speed bike around.
Sure. You don't have to brag about how many speeds, but okay.
Listen.
Some of us could only afford a 3-speed. I get it.
You're
a guy in Jersey with a 10-speed bike. We get it. You're rich.
We all have things. I had that. But I'll tell you, it was like riding a car. Like, I wouldn't even think about it. I could just go on my bike anywhere I wanted to go. It was
because you had so much lung capacity.
So much wind, yes.
So much wind is
the story of a young
so
man.
So much wind. Yeah. So much wind. That should be your catchphrase.
So much wind.
Guys, so much wind.
So much.
Coming in at number 4, Flashdance.
Oh, so good.
So good.
Speaking of a 10-speed. Love her. So
she
beautiful.
In a man's world.
Beals.
Still so hot.
So
she
hot.
Dances in a world of her dreams.
Her and
Flashdance.
Never was Pittsburgh so sexy.
Look at that.
She's just fucking welding the shit out of stuff.
But that's not all she is.
Oh, no. She's got some fucking moves.
Oh, Beals.
Yeah. Howard, breakdancing? Were you a breakdancer?
You know what? I couldn't breakdance. I had some physical issues.
Got it.
But I enjoyed it. And
I was heavy into breakdancing.
Oh, yeah?
Heavy.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
Where would you get your cardboard?
From boxes. I had a piece of the thing I had was I had a piece of not linoleum, what was it? I would use boxes, but then I had a piece of like really wood. It was like wood paneling is what it was.
Okay.
For like the wall, but we put it on the floor and it was super like, it was perfect.
Nice.
And I would just practice while my whole family would sit around and watch TV and I would just break dance. While we watched the Cosby Show. maniac.
What were you wearing?
I don't know.
Like Adidas tracksuit?
No. I didn't have any of the like accoutrement. I dressed like I normally dressed.
Were you good?
I mean, I could like do stuff, but wow. No, I wasn't good. You know?
Yeah, yeah.
I could pop and lock and do a bunch of spins
that's
and like
amazing.
I could do the windmill. That's
wow, that's cool.
I got as good as to be able to do the windmill.
Yeah.
And like that was that's as good as it got.
Yeah.
And then you just sort of, when did you stop? When you were like,
when I was 19 and my crew broke up because we'd been touring in Canada. No, I'm just kidding.
That would be amazing.
What do you mean? What do you mean, when did I stop? I'm a professional breakup.
Why stop?
Just doing windmills.
Hey, 19, as we talked about earlier, is it a good age to start taking things seriously?
Absolutely.
It sounds like you did it.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Was it hard for you to stay still?
What do you mean?
You're doing all these activities when you're breakdancing.
Yeah, yeah. I was like, the minute I hit like high school, I wanted to just do stuff. I did not want to be home anymore. I did not want to be like, I don't know. For whatever reason, I just was ready to like do stuff. And so I played the drums. I was in bands. I would just do anything. People were like, you want to do this? I'd be like, yeah, fuck yeah, let's do that.
Wow.
It's awesome.
Saying yes is a great way to get involved.
Yes,
in
and guys, yes, and it's the central tenet of improv.
Let me see what you wrote. Let me see what you wrote. Oh, say yes, and then you circled it. Yeah. It's beautiful. It's so beautiful. Coming in at number 3, Saturday Night Fever. Oh yeah.
Wacka doodle, wacka doodle, wow, wow. This movie has a pretty
stories
element to it.
Yeah.
I don't remember what. Tell me.
Oh, there is this movie basically ends on a rape and a suicide.
Yes.
Oh.
It does. Basically, you got the one kid who gets the girl pregnant. He's worried about an abortion.
Yep.
You got the brother who's going into the priesthood, but he's not sure if he wants to do it. You've got the chick who wants to dance with Tony at the club.
Yep.
I love the way you dance, Tony. You guys seen this?
Yeah.
I've seen it.
I saw it just a couple of years ago for the first time and was like,
oh, wow.
Whoa,
yeah.
What?
Yeah. Yeah, for something that was such a juggernaut, yeah. You wouldn't think it was as gritty as it was.
Super dark. There is super... Well, it's the same thing. I feel like there's a lot of... This movie, that like those elements would never be in a dance movie.
Right.
Now. There would never be a present-day dance movie that people needed abortions and blah. Though, the same way that you would never have like a teen coming-of-age romance movie like Fast Times where a girl has sex and gets pregnant and needs to get an abortion and blah. Like that. That kind of stuff I feel like doesn't exist now. It's either one thing or it's another thing. It's either a movie about a girl who needs an abortion or it's a movie about like teens having sex. And that's never...
Yeah, they're separate now. Yeah, back in the 70s, there was that gritty trend where everything was like Scorsese and Coppola and dirty.
Sure. Oh, yeah. Brian De Palma. Come on, guys.
Come on,
Carrie?
Carrie's crazy.
That's like a teen movie. I mean, it's a horror movie, obviously, but like... Yeah.
And
there's a new standard
for
bullying, which I think is good.
Wait, what?
Carrie had some great bullying at it.
Solid bullying.
He's a bully advocate.
Yeah.
Only in certain situations.
Yeah. How about Karate Kid?
What, was that bullying?
I mean, I'm pretty sure he was definitely being bullied.
Definitely.
That's why he started taking karate.
Okay. I've never really seen that movie.
What? Can we stop the whole thing right now? Start and just watch. Wait, what?
Why?
Who?
You
what?
Just...
I'd already...
Karate Kid?
I'd already pulled out of society at that point. I didn't need that kid.
At the point of Karate Kid?
Yeah, I was already out of that.
But how old were you? I mean...
Look, the point is this. I came up on Saturday Night Fever, Freebie and the Bean. Gritty 70s stuff. Now it's a candy ass kid in the 80s.
Yeah, all right.
It's Al from Happy Days.
All right, all right.
It's like, it's, I don't need it.
Happy Days.
It felt to me like like Saved by the Bell.
Yeah, see, I'm too old for... I never watched Saved by the Bell. I'm too old for that.
I love Saved by the Bell.
I'm unaware of it.
Saved by the Bell is a truly, truly horrible show.
Really?
April Richardson has a podcast where you watch Saved by the Bell. You watch an episode and then you comment on it.
I think it's called Bayside High.
Go Bayside. It's so bad. The show is awful.
But great stars came from it. We've got Dustin Diamond.
Lizzie Burks.
That's it.
Lizzie Burks.
Lizzie Burke, speaking of dance movies, is Showgirls on there?
It's not.
Surprise, surprise.
I didn't make
because it's a dance movie.
Certainly is
with like pussy lips,
right?
It's like that rare dance movie where you get to see like full lips.
Yeah, it's rated camel toe.
Yeah,
that sex scene
in the pool? Oh,
where
buddy.
She is just
oh my god,
she's basically spinning on his dick.
That's another one. That's another one. I mean, that's an edgier movie, but that's another one. Like straight up, like third act rape.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
You know, like, oh, boy. Like,
yeah,
shit gets crazy in that movie.
Right, which causes her to paint her nipples with lip gloss and get revenge.
Yep.
All these things necessary.
Because that's what you got to do when you're ready for revenge. You got to, it's like when in Greece, when Olivia Newton-John's transformation happens, she puts, like, the black leggings on and
yeah. Oh, that's true.
Does out her hair. When Elizabeth Berkley's transformation happens, she puts red lipstick around her areolas and goes and exacts revenge on the guy that raped her friend.
You know, you're going to want that. It empowers women, doesn't it, mm-hmm. to have that?
Why are you asking him?
Yeah. Well, we'll decide what's right,
right
for women.
Okay?
Don't worry about
it. We control your body. Yeah. Glossy,
did
glossy
you guys hear that the Pope is like, hey, Catholic Church, we're too obsessed with abortion and gay marriage. We need to fucking chill out.
Right, you're obsessed, he says.
Yeah, that's exactly it. I thought that was interesting.
I will say there are a myriad of issues facing the Catholic Church.
Do you guys have a Pope chart or a church chart?
We should.
Church, that's a good idea.
I mean, what would be on it, though?
Just, top five messiahs? That could work.
Top five messiahs. I love that.
Top five.
Except that it's like Jim Jones, David Koresh.
Yeah.
I just watched that Source Family documentary.
Oh, I haven't seen that yet.
Terrific.
It's great. Really?
In terms of like culty people who develop followers who think they're the messiah.
Right.
Yeah, it's a good one.
Were you up for that?
Yeah. I was up for that role in that documentary.
Were you up for that life?
Yep. I'm trying to get a cult going, guys.
Yeah?
It's not working.
It's tough. Is that what the Havasama is for you? Bid to have a cult?
Havasama is more of a lifestyle encouragement. A cult seems like it's got more of a dastardly method behind it.
I don't think they start out that way, but they certainly end up that way.
Right. Manson made it tough on everybody.
Oh, man.
A lot of guys were flying under the radar having a good time until then.
Coming in at number two, Black Swan.
Hmm. Ooh, dance movie, that's right.
Our new Swan Queen.
This one's intense.
Nina Sayers.
I'm Lily. You're going to be amazing.
She's so pretty.
I watch the way she moves.
Mila or
Mila? Well, she's beautiful too, but.
Seduce us. Attack it. Attack it. Come on.
I like him.
Where'd you get these? It's nothing. You sweet girl.
Barbara Hershey's so good in this movie.
Yeah. She the mom?
Yeah.
Because someone's hot for teacher. I don't want to talk about that.
This release was released on December 2010.
It's the role, isn't it?
106.9 million total gross. Black Swan.
I'll tell you what, you've got a black swan in your life.
I do?
Yeah.
Who's that? You?
June.
June's my black swan?
Yeah.
Wow.
Interesting. To your white swan.
I'm the white swan?
I don't know. Well, I haven't seen this movie in a while.
Oh, boy.
I saw this as a double feature, so I don't think
What was the first or the second movie?
There was another, maybe it was The Wrestler or The Fight. Which is the Mark?
The brother?
Which is Mark Wahlberg.
The Fighter.
Boxer. Was that the same year?
Is it The Fighter? What's it called?
Oh, no. What is that called? Shit.
That one's The Fight.
Isn't it called The Fighter?
Fighter.
Yeah. Wait, what's it called?
Is it The Fighter? Thanks.
Okay.
Are those the same? Did they come out the same time?
Probably.
Yeah. I think it was that.
That's a heavy double feat.
It's a heavy double feat. You know, Jason, you know this from being in the movie business.
Oh, I'm in the biz.
Towards the end of the year, they cram stuff.
Oh, yeah.
If you will.
Yep.
All the good movies.
Yep.
So it's around, you know, Oct, Nov, Dec, Jan, you start to feel like, hey, there's a lot of stuff and I haven't seen it yet.
Oh, absolutely.
We're coming up on it.
A lot of stuff.
We're coming up on it, guys.
Yeah, we're coming
gravity.
Up on it.
So I want to see
it's
Gravity.
It's already filled. It's already stuffed, it's right? And then they're still going to cram more in like the edges.
Whoa.
That's what
I'm saying. Pathos in your performance there, Kulap.
They're going to cram.
Oh, yeah.
Slower.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. Oh, yeah.
You know what? Trim your nails. You know what? Trim your nails.
Let me see. Are they jagged?
They're just long.
Okay. No, I think the nails are good. They work for you. Tweet at us what you would like on that. Hey, no, but the point is you may have to see some double features at this time of year in order to squeeze
in all
your
viewing. You got to cram those double feature.
Yeah.
But do you see June as a dangerous, mysterious figure? She's my black swan.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Do you concur?
I don't. This is the first I'm hearing of this.
Me too.
I'm curious. Do you? Yeah. I would like to. I mean, this is something that you guys are clearly uncovering.
Yeah.
You know, show by
show.
We're peeling it back. I'll tell you. I say do away with her now before you have some big problems.
Whoa.
That's right.
This is not what I expected.
Wow.
Yeah.
We're very close. We have a great relationship.
For
That's
now.
What you think. So
Wait,
you
what,
think.
Do you, what do you guys see that I don't see?
Keep your distance.
Yeah, just be careful.
Keep your distance.
She's capable of murder.
What do you know? Why are you saying that? Just, what have you seen?
Nothing. I'm just saying. Be careful. Watch your back.
Have you heard anything?
How about this?
I don't know if she's plotting something.
Forget what we're saying. Okay. Unless it becomes an issue, then you come back and apologize.
Yeah, there you go.
Whoa,
there
hold
you go.
On.
Perfect.
Right. Wow.
Jason buys that.
All right, guys. Any guesses who the number one is?
Oh, dance movie of all time?
Yeah.
Wait, what are the parameters?
No, 77 to present.
77 to present. Highest grossing dance movie's got to be Footloose.
All right. How about you?
Yeah, I'll agree with that.
Real Milk? What do you think?
I can see it.
Oh, that's right. Coming in at number one.
Number one.
Magic Mike.
Oh, really?
Oh, wow. Come on.
Footloose isn't even on this list.
That's insane.
Save the Last Dance?
That's
beats
insane.
Beats Footloose?
Beats Footloose. This total gross is $113.7 million.
And I'm surprised none of the
step-ups
made it.
Yeah, this must be adjusted gross free. If they adjusted the gross, I think we'd have...
No, but we got Saturday Night Fever and Flashdance there.
Actually, no idea.
It's probably in the top 10. Did you end up seeing this?
I did not.
Because I know we were going
to
keep...
I have the same problem with this as I do with going to Burning Man.
Oh, do tell.
I'm
a lot of dong.
Where this is going.
Lot too much dong in my face.
Oh, interesting.
Wait, are there dongs aplenty at Burning Man?
Oh, everybody's naked at Burning Man. Every time you see pictures from Burning Man, it's like some fat naked slob riding a bike.
That's
and it's
right.
Like, can you believe Burning Man? And at this point, yeah. I can fucking believe it.
I mean,
put some goddamn shorts on.
That's how I am, dude. Would you ever go?
I would go to Burning Man. Yeah, I would go just for the experience of what is this?
When,
you know?
When they have like a Google Glass that could like do a dong block, then I'll go. Just
wait,
like,
wait, how would
well,
that
see,
work?
my problem isn't like I'm. Listen, if I see a bunch of dongs, that's fine. But in my mind, I'm like, everybody here is just filthy. Like touching dongs and butts and boobs and pussies constantly.
I was going to ask you.
So I don't want anybody to touch me. I don't want to eat anything. I mean, it's like a city constructed in the desert, you know, like with a bunch of like opium smoking hippies making me fucking tacos. Like, come on, guys. I would go in like my own trailer with all my own food, I think.
Right.
And I would pass out shorts.
Would Burning Man be the last place you'd eat M&M's?
Yes. For sure.
That'd be a tough one.
Yeah.
Really hard.
The dong. Here's the thing about the dongs at Burning Man. You're probably going to take some drugs.
Yeah.
Sure.
You know, drugs affect your perception.
Uh-huh.
They magnify things.
Certainly other dongs,
There you go. So, you know what I mean?
Oh, wow. Like monster dongs coming at you.
Right.
Oof.
Oof.
The horror.
We've all been there.
And it's hot. You don't want that. No, Moshe Kasher goes to that.
It was a terrible high five. That high five was an embarrassment.
Do you want to do better?
Does he? Did he go this year?
Yeah, he went this year. I didn't get these stories back from him, but...
Ow!
Wow!
Ow.
Look at these two.
Ow!
Wow!
Ow.
See, that's how you high five. Those are fucking solid high fives.
Moshe Kasher goes every year. He went this year, and as I understand it, he helps with the parking.
I guess, yeah.
Yeah, and in exchange, there's VIP areas or something like that?
Yeah, he gets a VIP treatment.
Is there a comedy tent at Burning Man? Legit question.
I think people are thinking
about it.
Because there isn't, like, music, right? It's not like a festival.
I feel like it's all a drum circle. I feel like the whole thing's a drum circle.
It's a drum, but it's also, it's like people set up their own little worlds. So if there's sound systems, I guess people play music and stuff.
Got it.
There's probably bands that play, but... I don't think it's like tent. It's not like a tent situation.
The element that you bring up is why I won't ever go. I like the
grimy
shower,
dirtiness of it. Yeah,
like
exactly.
Right.
And that's the thing is everybody's in the middle of the desert for like 3 days without showers or clothes, and all they're doing is fucking each other. Right. And I feel like everybody's covered in like jizz and
sand
juice.
And dust and ugh.
We'd go glamping. If they had glamping, we'd do it.
What's glamping?
Like glamorous camping.
Ooh, I like that.
Yeah. I'm into that. Better yet, a cabin, you know, just a luxurious cabin.
Oh, I'd love to bring a cabin.
Hello.
What if we drove into the cabin and just dumped it on the ground in the desert, and we're like, fuck it, we're here with our goddamn cabin.
Because that's what all the like Burning Man people are upset that a bunch of like .com people are coming.
Oh,
like,
is that
the,
right?
The Facebook guy came for like a day.
Oh, really?
Zuckerberg came. Didn't he come in like a helicopter or something like that?
No, really?
You know what I would bring is just a chain link fence.
That's not the spirit.
I would just show up with my stuff and a fence, put it up.
I love this.
That's my own freedom.
I love this. And attack dogs.
Yeah.
And attack dogs, yeah. And a guard tower.
And a sniper.
Yeah. And a,
I know, but then it's like, how much setup for 3 days, though? I mean, the teardown alone, is it worth your time?
I wouldn't tear it down. I would just leave. Leave it there like a monument.
No, what you should do is you just light, it's Burning Man. You just light it all on fire.
Oh, there you go.
I think that's what you do at Burning Man.
Yeah,
everything you don't want to take home with you, you just light on fire.
Is that true?
I'm just realizing I don't know anything about Burning Man.
Me neither.
They burn a big man at the end. I know that.
And that's
why
name.
Tall John won't go.
And he's flammable as hell, that guy. Seeing him catch.
All right, let's take a quick break, our final break, before we answer your questions from Facebook, your YouTube comments, and, of course, Twitter. Jason, you're on Twitter, right?
Shut up!
Woof!
We used to date. We are back at Who Charted Live on the Video Podcasting Network. I'm Cuckoo.
Hi, Wee Wee.
And we're with...
Jason Mantzoukas.
The Zooks.
Are you all right?
Yeah, I just wanted to whisper it that time. I screamed it the last time.
That's true. That's true.
I'm just giving you guys a variety of options.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Feel free to isolate those and use them as your outgoing voicemail message.
Oh.
Really? I can do that?
Yeah.
That's not going to weird you out.
Hello, you've reached Jason Mantzoukas. Jason Mantzoukas. That's a pretty good impression.
Jason Mantzoukas. Now it's time to answer all of your questions. A lot of these are for you. It's exciting for everyone to be able to reach you in this way, Jason. But we've got some for
it's
Howard.
It's my worst nightmare.
Is it? They're all silly, great questions.
Okay, good.
Well, let's be the judge, right?
Let's go.
Yes.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Let's
I
do
love
it.
It.
All right, here's some questions. This is from Brandon Noonan. Jason, what is your favorite movie you have done for How Did This Get Made?
Brandon Noonan?
Noonan.
Noonan? Brandon Noonan.
Yeah.
What's my favorite movie? Who did for us? Well, I mean, the Crank movies, Crank 2 is like just awesome.
Yeah.
I love that
movie.
Is
that better than the first one?
Yeah, it is.
It's got Bailing.
It's super heightened and way crazier than the first one, which is already heightened
and
crazy.
Yeah, that was crazy. I saw some of that this weekend.
Yeah. And then that's probably one of my favorites. And then I do love unabashedly Fast 5 and 6. Fast and Furious 5 and Fast and Furious 6.
Well, that actually, there's a question here about that. Nope, that's about your shirts. Jason,
here we go.
Are you trying to get a part in Fast Furious 7? If not, I'm starting a movement. That's from Peter Fadden.
Okay, here we go. Peter Fadden. Peter Fadden and Brandon Noonan.
Noonan.
Everybody has double letters in their name. I'm going to say this. I auditioned for Fast and Furious 7.
Uh-huh.
I got a call to come in and audition for a part in Fast and Furious 7. I did not get that part.
I'm
here to announce that I did not get that part.
Chart exclusive.
Oof.
It went to, when you see the movie, I suspect you'll see what part they asked me to play, and you'll be like, oh, they got an actual Middle Eastern gentleman to play that part.
Yeah.
Got it.
Not a guy who looks like a Middle Eastern gentleman and sometimes plays one on TV and movies.
Howard, are you ever allowed to reveal your summer secret? This is from Temporary Chair.
You know, by a secret is something that you don't tell anybody. And once you do, I doubt that it still exists as a secret. So I'm going to say no, although my summer secret was fantastic this year. And
what's a summer secret?
Oh, a summer secret is something you do during the summer that you don't tell anybody else about.
Oh,
it's
nice.
Your secret.
I like that.
And
my throughout the summer or like once?
It could be a one-time incident. It could be something you do one night. For me, it was something that happened over the course of the summer.
Ooh.
That had to be maintained every day.
Whoa.
Okay, but then... Oh, what?
And you don't say what it is?
But then when summer is done...
When summer's done, I might reveal it.
Oh, okay.
Even
okay.
though you're not supposed to, but we're in a business where sharing is caring. So, actually, this is the last Thursday of summer, so I will not be able to reveal it tonight.
Ooh.
Oh, boy.
Oh, man, I hope I get asked back for the next
reveal.
We will do that. We'll have
I
Jason
want that reveal.
That reveal.
To everybody at the table, what's the worst injury you've had? This is from Melissa Andrade. Worst injury.
I broke my leg playing soccer in high school.
Ooh.
Both tibia and fibula.
Mm-hmm.
Clean break. Really, like a lot of like.
That's I could hear that breaking.
It was. People heard it like 100 yards away.
Yeah, like
the
loud
stands.
Snap.
The stands were on the other side, and I was going for a ball. I was not wearing shin guards. I was going for a ball, and a guy who was wearing shin guards was going for a ball. We both missed the ball and hit. Our shins hit each other, and the bottom of my leg just kept snapped, and Joe Theismann like just kept going, and it was like I lay down on the ground, and my leg went like my leg had like two knees in it. It looked like it was like bent at the knee, and then another like. You know, big, almost 90-degree bend in the middle of my shin.
Ugh.
It was a nightmare.
When did the pain kick in?
Not until I woke up in the hospital.
No,
it was pure, insane shock for like an hour.
Jesus.
Just like paralyzing, fearful shock. And I was loaded into a station wagon and brought. I was playing a scrimmage in like a northern Massachusetts town, like far away from home, and was like put in a station wagon and brought to like a janky hospital. They set my leg incorrect.
Ah.
So I then, like 2 months later, had to go to a doctor who rebroke my leg.
Jesus.
And I destroyed all of like the nerves and everything in my leg. And he had me put my leg over the side of the table, and he just held my foot, held my calf, and went pop.
Ah.
So that he now was holding two independent pieces connected only with skin. Redid it, and then went beep, and then put a new cast on. It was one of the weirdest feelings.
God, that's
ever.
So odd. He just did it with his bare hands.
Yeah.
Jesus.
It was pretty intense, guys.
Top that.
I opened the freezer door for some ice cream and an iron pot hit my head.
That's all? No breakage?
Right, where was this iron pot?
My mom owned a Thai restaurant.
Oh, it was like on top of the freezer?
Yeah, and the pot that they made, like egg roll filling, didn't get pushed all the way in.
Got it.
So I opened this like big industrial.
Gang.
And then I had to get stitches on nothing like that.
Oh, no. I mean, plus I've like almost died a million times from eating eggs.
Oh, right.
Oh, yeah.
So there's that too.
There's that.
Mine would have to be, I was jumping over lounge chairs at my swim club as a youth, and I fell forward into the corner of a brick wall. Right there.
Oof.
The top corner of the brick hit me right in the head there.
And your head bleeds a lot.
Yeah,
we know that from June.
Ton of blood coming through there. And I remember I had to walk by the kiddie pool to get to the front office to tell him I was hurt.
Oh, boy.
And the lifeguard at the kiddie pool was like, should be more careful.
No.
Be careful out there. And I was like gushing blood down my face.
My impulse upon seeing that would be, I got to help that kid. And then I'd be like, that's blood.
Right.
I got to stay away.
Stay away. No, he was just
I don't
like,
know what this kid's up to.
Yeah, he was just like, hey, behave yourself. And
be cool.
Six stitches across the skull there.
Oof.
Yeah.
Ouch.
That was tough.
Tough stuff.
And I broke my fifth metacarpal on Tyrone Kuzu's face, and I fight behind my middle school.
I broke my nose in a car accident.
Ooh. Oh. Wow.
Yeah, my nose was already enormous, so it didn't register that much.
Easy to break.
Yeah. Yeah. No, it didn't have too far to travel between where I was sitting and hitting the windshield.
That car just hit your nose.
Yeah.
Your car's fine.
Yeah, exactly.
Howard, do you feel any kind of summer rivalry with Vacation Jason? Are you brothers in summer? This is from Bags of Fat.
You know, I'm not totally familiar with his work. I know he's up to something cool because people have mentioned him, but it's just always been to where, like, I didn't have time to Google it.
Jason. Who's Vacation Jason?
It's Vacation Jason, I think, is a guy. He does music, too.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry, Vacation Jason. I think you must be doing some great stuff that I need to check out, and then we'll do like a Watch the Throne tour together in the future.
Who are you listening to right now, Howard, that you really like?
I like Major Lazer a lot right now.
I like that Major Lazer.
I like 2 Chainz very much right now.
Sure.
ASAP Rocky.
Love that ASAP Rocky. Kendrick Lamar. How do you feel about Kendrick Lamar?
Kendrick Lamar's growing on me, although I will say
that. How do you feel about Earl Sweatshirt?
Earl Sweatshirt needs to grow on me a little bit more. Okay. I would say, like, those guys are all very skillful.
Yep.
But as far as just, like, booty jams, having fun.
I'll tell you what. I'll listen to that French Montana record.
Oh, yeah.
That's a great record.
That is fun.
That is a good record.
He's an entertaining rapper.
Yes.
Don't forget to be an entertaining rapper.
Agree.
Yes.
Jason, when was the last time you cried? This is from Cat and Beard.
Oh, I mean, like, I cry constantly.
Mm-hmm.
I cried. What did I recently cry at? I cried at a movie. What did I watch recently? I cried.
Wonder.
Okay, I can't remember what I cried at something recently that I can't remember that got me, and I was like, oh man, that really got me. But I did recently text someone because I was home and I watched. What did I just cry?
Documentary.
No, I cried at one of our movies, a How Did This Get Made movie, and was like, oh no, this is not good. Like, I got like caught up in something. I wish I could remember.
What is it?
The listeners will know because I admitted it on the podcast.
It was something you'd already made fun of on the show.
We were making fun of it, and I was like, this moment made me cry.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. No, that shit happens a lot where I cried at Pitch Perfect recently. Why? Don't know. I don't remember what scene. I was watching Pitch Perfect and I cried during it. I was like, something's happening. I've become very emotional. I'm like Tony Soprano, I feel like. Something happened, I saw some ducks, and now I can't get it together emotionally. Like, some shit is off.
Well, they do say as you age as a male, your brain gets softer and more emotions get in there easier.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, great. I'm looking forward to it.
Scott's going to be a weeper.
You know why? Because I feel like all it is like I am constantly recognizing my own mortality.
Yeah.
Like, constantly. There's a certain age I feel like you hit where it's like, oh, right, I'm going to die sooner rather than later.
Right.
You know?
Yeah, I've done most of the stuff.
Yeah.
Howard, do you feel like you've done most of the stuff?
I feel like in order to squeeze in what I should have accomplished by now, I'm going to have to live to about 110.
Oh, boy. And what are you doing to make sure that you live till then?
Oh, I've cut out meat. Mm-hmm. I'm a lot less dairy.
Really?
I'm getting exercise.
You love your pizza.
Pizza is a tough one to get rid of.
You know what movie I cried all the way through? One thing happened in the movie, I cried for the rest of the movie.
What?
It was Mike Mills' Beginners. Ewan McGregor.
Movie. That's a good,
Christopher
great movie.
Plummer.
R.E.M. Mike Mills
Different
joke,
Mike
everybody.
Mills. Different Mike Mills.
Are we so we're talking movies that made us cry?
Sure.
Or anything that didn't say anything that made you cry?
Yeah.
Or was it a movie?
No, it was any. When was the last time you cried? How about you, Howard? Do you remember?
I cried. I almost cried watching a Friday Night Lights. The kid got into college. Smash. And
that show makes me cry.
Yeah.
Like, that show's a real heartbreaker.
Show.
Yeah, it's really good. So
see, okay, everybody, I'm going to quickly read all these. Why don't you have Twitter still? Why do you hate Twitter? Why was your use of Twitter stopped after your appearance on #230PST? Ask Zooks why he still isn't on Twitter.
Yeah, guys, I'm not on Twitter.
He's not on Twitter.
It's not going to happen.
It's just never going to happen.
Is it because of 230PST?
No, I got on Twitter for that show for half an hour.
Oh.
And there was a lot of reaction to that.
Okay.
Because that's a funny story because I didn't know that show was all on Twitter. So I got there and they were like, oh, we opened a Twitter account for you so you can participate in the show. And I was like, what? I don't even. So the show's only half an hour, the majority of which was me asking the rest. rest of the panelists how to use Twitter. Like, how do you post something? How do I retweet? So it was...
The fans were the winners that day.
I thought it was adorable. I'm sure it was annoying.
And in a nutshell, Twitter no good for you because...
Yeah, I don't think it's good. I don't think it's right. I don't know what I have to say that I need to tell people about.
Right.
And I don't... I don't know what I would do with it, you know? That's it, really. I don't know what I would say. I could see getting into, like, Instagram, maybe, or something. Like, I could see, like, taking a picture and putting that. I get.
Yeah.
But I don't think in a way that I'm like, ooh, I want to tweet this thought out to these, you know, people who follow me. I don't know.
Pinterest.
I am on Pinterest.
I would do Pinterest, but for myself to gather stuff.
Yeah.
I would not do it to reveal to people that I'm looking at a number of different apothecary jars.
But you know what?
There's only 3 secret boards, though, so you would have to.
If you wanted to get some hot chicks, you would do that.
Is that what it is?
Really?
Pinterest is all chicks.
Oh, yeah. And that's like same as Etsy. I feel like Etsy's all chicks.
Etsy's chicks.
Etsy's not a social media thing, but that's where I go to buy apothecary jars.
That's why I brought it up. It's like home design.
Yeah, that stuff,
like,
I love.
Yeah,
that stuff I love. But the element that I don't need is the social element.
The interaction.
The part of it that I don't need is people talking to me or me talking to people.
Right. All that.
I'm a real misanthrope, guys. Get it through your skulls.
You dum dums.
I don't want to talk to you.
I want some social isolation sites where no one can touch me on.
Oh, I love that.
Really?
I'm like, how about this? What about this? Maybe I'll pull a J.D. Salinger.
Okay.
And I'll do like 5 years worth of tweets that I don't tweet. And then when I'm dead, they'll release all of my tweets.
I like that a lot.
Did you see that, Doc?
Can I top?
No, I haven't seen it yet.
I haven't either.
Oh, no. I was going to add to that a tombstone that has your Twitter feed on it.
I love that.
So that you can...
Yep.
It's just scrolling constantly. Your thoughts are never dead.
And that's the only way that people can then go and see my tweets.
Right.
Is on my
tombstone.
LED tombstone.
That's kind of cool.
I do. That's pretty cool, actually.
Guys, we have so many questions here, but I don't think we're going to get to them. We've run out of time.
For real? There's a time limit on this?
Yeah, I mean, we're supposed to be 10 at 7.
Oh, is that right? Oh,
yeah.
Okay. Oh, sorry.
I mean, if you just want to comment on your white shirts, good? Are you covered? Howard,
need to comment on that. I don't even know what you're talking about.
Your white Oxfords? Yeah. Oh, well, there's a few questions here. Let's see. Do you buy that shirt in bulk or just wash it daily? And how many white Oxfords would you recommend a young man like myself get to start off my wardrobe? That's from Toby Keith Sweat.
As many white Oxfords as you want to buy, you know? How many do you feel like you need?
6.
I mean, I would say, you know, like you should have quite a few. It depends on how often you're going to wear it.
Sure.
If you're going to wear one often, you might need upwards of 20 white shirts.
You look like a grad student. You look like a guy who's waiting tables.
Thank you.
You look like a scholar.
Thank you.
You look like an actor.
I'll take it.
You look like a funeral director.
All right. Interesting.
Really?
Yeah. You could be a casual? Lot of things in a white Oxford.
A lot of people don't look at me and say, you look like a funeral director.
Well, I mean, in that shirt, you could be, you know, you could easily convince someone that is your job.
I want to move towards your direction in dress because I don't want to think about it anymore.
Do it.
Sometimes I
mean, I don't know what you mean, but do it.
But we're not just like, you know, that fits you. You know,
yep.
You like how it is.
Same
you don't
thing.
Have to think so much about
Absolutely.
It.
Absolutely. Yeah. Why not?
You do that in summer. You wear your swim trunks and your T-shirts.
I do that. I do.
You do. Jason, thank you so much for coming back
on
the show.
Thank you. I love this show.
You're the best.
You're the best.
Okay, so we have the League episode coming up.
Yeah, League. That episode's next week, I believe. Yeah. And then the League's continuing. I'll be on a bunch of other episodes.
How many episodes this year?
How many will I be on?
No, just...
I believe they're doing 12 or 13, and I'm in 5 or 6 of them. I can't remember.
That's a nice run.
Yeah.
You're beloved.
Oh, thanks.
Rafi's beloved.
It is really funny how much people love unadmitted murderer, rapist, sociopath on television. Like, people are like, oh, the guys on the League are so terrible, but I love Rafi. Rafi is the worst of the guys on the League.
There's a charm to him, though. This
he's a lovable sociopath.
Any other projects that we should look out for?
I mean, yes, but not right now.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
Oh, How Did This Get Made, of course.
Of course.
I will always plug How Did This Get Made every week on the Earwolf, blah, 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 blah.
What's the next movie that you guys are going to talk about?
Toys.
Oh.
Toys, the Robin Williams movie, Toys.
Oh, great.
Oh, God. Yeah. That was a mess.
Howard, what's going on with
you? Oh, pick up a newly easy-to-get Austin Stories on eBay. Pick up a album of mine on Bandcamp. There's 5 to choose from. It's coming up on 6. And check out Who Charted. Check out the Who Charted holiday bundle. That could be coming your way.
Ooh, bundles.
And, love bundles.
Yeah. And check out everything at howardkramer.com, Twitter, Instagram.
Yep. Follow me on Twitter at Kulap, on Instagram at I Am Kulap. And we will hear or see love on you next week on
Who Charted.